Hey guys, Kyle the Completionist here, and welcome back to my cringy commentary of Mass Effect 1. Alright, well, shit really hit the fan in the last episode. We finally confronted Saren, the evil mastermind behind all of this shit we've gone through, or at least, we thought he was the mastermind. But it turns out there's something even worse. That giant metal Cthulhu hand ship he has was actually giant metal Cthulhu, and it's going to try and take over the universe and all that other stuff. I don't know what I'm saying at this point. Just ignore me, people. The point is, we've got a lot of work to do. And poor Ashley, she didn't make it. She died. I had the decision to save her or Caden. What the hell? Presley, you okay, buddy? I'll just leave you up there.
Yes, Commander?
Goodbye.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, sir.
Presley, don't scare me like that. Okay, where was I? Oh, yeah, so I saved Caden, but Ashley didn't make it. Probably one of those pivotal moments in the game, because it basically affects events in the rest of the trilogy, because Caden and Ashley are both, they're both main characters in Mass Effect 3, but since you can only save one of them in this game, you know, kind of makes things play out quite differently. Anyway, talk to Joka.
Commander, I know it couldn't have been easy for you down there. Making the call between Elenko and Williams must have been... I'm sorry, sir, I don't know if I could have done it.
I had to do it. Naturally, no, I'll go with the middle option.
There was no other choice. The mission is more important than one soldier.
No, I'm not blaming you, Commander. I'm just... I mean, it's hard, you know?
Are you all right?
Saren's still out there, Joker. Hold it together. We need you.
Don't worry, I won't let you down. I want to be there when you make that son of a bitch pay.
Ooh, Joker's getting bloodthirsty. Good.
I'll be okay, Commander. Just need some time.
See you, Joker. Alright. Let's go down, talk to our squad mates. I'm sure they have quite a bit of stuff to say about all of this. Go, 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 go. Caden, you okay, buddy?
Anything you need, Commander?
Tactical appraisal.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Input? Hell, I don't know. We're fighting giant machines from outside the galaxy. Should I be afraid of them? Or in awe of them? Anything so old, so intelligent.
Eh, who cares? We'll be them anyway, because we're awesome.
We may be ants to them, but humans have never managed to exterminate ants.
It makes you wonder, are ants any more aware than we were of the giants that walk over their heads?
Personal input.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
We're all in for the duration. You can count on everyone to do their duty.
About Williams.
I wanted to see how you're dealing with Ash's death.
Dealing, sir. Sorry for anything I said back there. Adrenaline.
I understand.
I don't like losing people either, Elenko.
I've served for years, but never lost a soldier under my command. Not to hostile action, anyway. If you don't mind my asking, how did you deal with the losses on Akuz?
I vowed to do better.
It was my job to get everyone out safe. I failed. I vowed not to let that happen again. Same here. I'll remember her, and I'll do better for her.
Yeah, I guess that's all we can do. Thanks for the advice, sir.
Goodbye.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
All right, talk to Liara.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
All right, nothing there. Liara.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
Weird. We have this conversation every time after our main mission on Aguli. It's a weird glitch.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I've been thinking about Saren. I actually feel a little sorry for him now.
Don't.
He's no innocent victim. He was a ruthless bastard long before he fell under Sovereign's control.
I know his reputation, but he was a Spectre. I think he honestly believed everything he did was for the greater good. I wonder how he first fell into Sovereign's trap. Did he think he could somehow stop the Reapers from returning? Or was he simply driven by a lust for power and glory?
I'd say the latter. In the novels, you find out he wanted to use Sovereign as a weapon against humanity. Because he has some irrational hatred for us. Because of the death of his brother, I believe. Well, it's better explained in the novels, but that's kind of the gist of it. Does it matter?
Whatever Saren's reasons may have been, they're long gone now. He has to be stopped.
Yes, I suppose you're right. He may be Sovereign's victim, but he is also a threat to all life as we know it. Let's not spend every free minute talking about Saren. It is bad enough we are chasing him across the galaxy.
Yeah, goodbye.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander. I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
No. I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
See ya. Alright, let's go down and talk to our crew. Come on, come on. Go, go, go. Okay. Talk to these guys.
It was an honor working with you, Commander Shepard. Despite the losses, our mission was a success. My superiors will duly honor Chief Williams for her actions. Her sacrifice has earned humanity a great deal of respect from my people.
I'll miss her.
Ash was a hell of a soldier. She knew what the risks were, but she did what she had to.
Of course. The grim reality that every soldier must accept. Rest assured, Commander, my men and I will not forget what you have accomplished here. We will leave your ship as soon as you reach your next destination. Perhaps we will have the opportunity to work together again someday.
Sounds good. Yeah, making sure he survived the mission is important for Mass Effect 3. He kind of comes back and helps you out.
My superiors will hear of this. You have made an ally of the Salarian people. I salute you and all of your officers. My men were concerned about teaming with you, but your actions have earned their respect.
Good to know.
We will work together again. I am certain of it.
You have my gratitude, Commander. Most people would have left our team behind. The captain considers the mission a success. I defer to his judgment.
Show me your supplies.
Let me see what you have.
All right. Buy up these upgrades. Okay. Talk to Rex.
Commander, things got heated back on Virmire. You did what you had to do. I respect your choice.
Thank you.
I appreciate what you did, Rex. I won't forget it.
Just make sure it was worth it. Saren has to pay for what he's done.
Oh, he will.
No matter what it takes, I'm gonna hunt him down and kill it.
I like the sound of that.
Goodbye.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Right, Garrus.
Commander, I wanted to thank you.
What for, Garrus? For
this way, we'll know he'll never hurt again. Don't worry, I will.
Alright.
Looking for supplies?
Yep.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Okay. Anything, like this. I am planning to take Garrus and Tally along on the final mission, so I have these. I don't know if they're any better than what I already have, but it really doesn't matter. I have so much money, I can waste it. Alright. Oh, and equip. I noticed I have this in my inventory, but not that. This thing. The Predator L8. Considerable boost to shield, so that's good. Alright. Every bit of protection helps. Talk to Tally.
Hey, Shepard. You need something?
Nope.
I should go.
See you later.
I guess that's it then.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Alright. That was it then. And now we come to one of the more painful scenes to witness in the Mass Effect trilogy. Well, you'll see what I mean.
I forwarded the mission update to the Citadel, Commander. We got confirmation on those reinforcements. Ambassador Udina wants us to report back to the Citadel. The Council's massing a joint species fleet to deal with Saren and his Geth.
I can't believe he would fall for that. About time.
Took them long enough. Back to the Citadel, Joker. I want the Normandy at the head of that fleet.
Yes, sir.
Considering how crappy the last conversation with the Council went, don't you think Shepard would be more suspicious of their motives here?
Good job, Shepard. Thanks to you, the Council's finally taking real action against Saren.
The Ambassador is correct. If Saren is foolish enough to attack the Citadel, as you believe, we will be ready for him.
Patrols are stationed at every mass relay linking Citadel space to the Terminus systems.
That's not enough.
You think a blockade's going to stop him? He's on Ilos looking for the conduit right now. What are you doing about that?
Ilos is only accessible to the Mule Relay, deep inside the Terminus systems, Commander. If we send a fleet in there, the only possible outcome is full-scale war.
Now is the time for discretion, Commander. Saren's greatest weapon was secrecy. Exposed, he is no longer a threat. This is over.
War against who? The Terminus systems are just a bunch of pirate gangs. Pretty sure, they're afraid of a bunch of low-life pirates. I kill those guys on, these guys are like a... I kill a lot of them, that's the point. I just don't... What about, send me after him?
One ship going into the Terminus systems won't start a war. I can be discreet.
You detonated a nuclear device on Virmire. I wouldn't call that discreet.
Your style served you well in the Traverse, Commander. We recognize that. But Ilos requires a deft touch. We have the situation under control.
What about the conduit?
Secrecy isn't his greatest weapon. The conduit is.
Saren is a master manipulator. The conduit is just a distraction from his real plan to attack the Citadel.
And the Reapers?
Sovereign's the real threat. Saren's just a servant of the Reapers.
Only you have seen the Reapers, and then only in visions. We won't invade the Terminus Systems because of a dream.
I don't suppose they have an audio recording of the conversation with Sovereign, do they? That worked last time. Then you're all fools.
If Saren finds the conduit, we're all screwed. We have to go to Ilos.
Ambassador Udina, I get the sense Commander Shepard isn't willing to let this go.
There are serious political implications here, Shepard. Humanity's made great gains thanks to you, but now you're becoming more trouble than you're worth.
You bastard! You're selling us out!
It's just politics, Commander. You've done your job, now let me do mine. We've locked out all the Normandy's primary systems until further notice you're grounded.
You son of a bitch! I never saw this coming!
Nobody stabs me in the back, Udina. Nobody.
I think it's time for you and your team to leave, Commander. This no longer concerns you. The Council can handle this, with my help, of course.
Great. Wah, wah, wah.
Commander, I've got a message from Captain Anderson.
Give me the message.
What did he want?
Only said to meet him in that club in the wards. Flux.
Alright, took on Tally and Daguerus. Let's go.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
Alright. Who are you?
Sorry, Commander. The Normandy's locked down. Ambassador Udina gave the order. Sorry, Commander. The Normandy's locked down. Ambassador Udina gave the order.
Shut up. Heard you the first time. Alright. I've got a couple of side missions to do before... Huh. Interesting outfit. Alright. So, let's do those before we talk to Anderson and Flux.
Reporter Kalisa Al-Jilani recently attempted to land an interview with Commander Shepard, the first human Spectre. Commander Shepard answered difficult questions, demonstrating that under that military uniform is a keen diplomatic mind. We'll have exclusive footage later today.
Thanks, I guess? I thought she hated me. Kalisa Al-Jilani. Whoa. Okay, come on. Go. Alright. Let's head to, head for the wards, because that's where the side missions are. And Flux, so that's convenient.
A research station on Novaria has reportedly been destroyed. The exact cause is currently unknown. Given the research conducted on Novaria, many are blaming the destruction on an experiment gone awry. Administrator Anoleus currently faces criminal charges as a result of the disaster, although the nature of the charges remains unclear.
I thought they were gonna blame it on the weather. It was a really nasty storm, you see. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Come on, come on, get me out of here. I always thought this hallway was kind of eerie. I don't know why, it just is. Alright. Let's save before I talk to these people up ahead. Also, upgrade. Alright. Oops.
Excuse me! You're the Spectre, right?
Yep, that's me.
Remember Shanxi!
Who are these guys?
No blood for aliens!
Yeah.
Terra firma.
Yes.
Huh. Go it alone.
Now we've heard of Terra firma before. Let's talk
Throw
to
the
this.
Appeasers out.
Talk to this guy.
Commander Shepard, it is an honor to speak with you.
What do you want?
You obviously wanted to speak with me.
I'm Charles Saraceno of the Terra Firma Party. With Armistice Day coming soon, we're making our voices heard by the alien appeasers on the Presidium. Can I count on your support in the next election?
Armistice Day.
You're marking the end of the First Contact War with a protest?
As we have every year for the last 26 years. The war taught humanity a lesson that some would forget. If we don't stand up for ourselves, no one else will.
Okay, don't agree with either of these, so I'll just ignore that. The election.
What are you running for?
I'm seeking one of the 5 spacer seats in Parliament. They have certain Baroque conditions for a citizen to be able to vote for them. You have to spend more than 6 months a year in space. But you can't have stayed in any one settled system for more than a month. You do spend most of your time in space, Commander.
True enough. What is Terra Firma?
I don't know Terra Firma's platform. What do you stand for?
Our core value is that Earth must stand firm against alien influences. Politically, culturally, and in the worst case, militarily.
But many of your subordinates make this a point of race, not politics.
Excuse me, I don't believe human politics are any of your business.
Turian space borders yours. Of course we're concerned about your leadership.
Huh. Interesting that I brought Garrus along to this. I guess I'll go with this one. I don't know.
We live in this galaxy, Mr. Saraceno. We can't pretend that what we do affects no one else.
No, of course not. My apologies. I only meant to point out that other species have no right to interfere in Alliance politics.
Yeah, that is true. So basically, there's like 2 different extremes here. There's like the Earth must walk alone, and then there's the... You got a guy like Udina, who's the other extreme, just, you know, bend over for whatever the aliens want. That's why I prefer Anderson, because he's like the healthy middle of the two. I think I will support this guy simply because I feel like it would help balance out the power a bit. Because Udina is sort of the one... Because Udina has a lot of influence right now, and there's not really much, like... Like, I feel like having someone who's, like, staunchly... You know... I don't know what you would call it, like... I just feel like the two would balance each other out. It's like, even though I don't agree with either of them, I feel like by at least putting them both together, it would, both of their negatives would cancel out, if that makes any sense. I don't know.
I'm a patriot, Mr. Saraceno. You've got my vote.
It is gratifying to hear that. We can't allow anything like Shanxi to happen again. Since I have your vote, could I convince you to issue a public statement of support for my candidacy? The support of the first human Spectre would be invaluable.
Shanxi.
The occupation of Shanxi couldn't happen again. We weren't even sure there were aliens to garrison against back then.
It's still a powerful symbol, Commander. Shanxi is the only human territory ever occupied by an alien species.
What about Mindwar? Well, I guess it wasn't occupied, but... You have my support.
We need more politicians with the courage to stand up for human rights.
Excellent. I'll have my people contact you. Don't worry. We'll take care of everything. Thank you for your time, Commander. Remember Terra Firma on Election Day, because Terra Firma remembers you.
Aliens off Earth!
I find it bizarre that, like, these people are allowed to, like,
freedom isn't free.
Have these anti-alien protests on the Citadel, of all things. Like, how are they just allowed to do that? Yeah, we bleed red. It's...
I have to work the crowd, Commander. Maybe we can do lunch sometime?
Sure. See ya. In all honesty, this decision has really no... It really has no impact on anything. And I think maybe, like, there's, like, one little thing you might hear about in Mass Effect 2, but that's about it. Nothing really big.
Pardon me, soldier. Can I take a moment of your time?
Elias Keeler.
Soldier, I've got a major situation, and I need help from somebody with humanity's interests at heart.
What is it?
It's Commander, actually. What do you want?
Of course, right to business. That's why humanity has the best damn fleet in the galaxy. My name is Elias Keeler. I'm an Alliance negotiator. We've got a big session coming up with the Salarians. You wouldn't believe what's riding on this. I'm fighting for humanity on this one, just like you are.
You're a pencil pusher. Cut the act.
Don't try to sell me on this. Just tell me what you want.
I need you to buy a mental stimulant for me. It's legal, but restricted. I've purchased the monthly limit, and I need more from the medbay.
Are you asking me for drugs? What the fuck? What is this drug?
What is this stimulant exactly?
Oh, I don't know the medical terms, but it increases mental capacity, short-term recall, that sort of thing. It helps me stay focused, and it keeps me sharp. Nothing gets by me when I'm on it.
Should try Metagel. Heals you up even when you're dead. Bad joke. Drug dosage.
If you know the monthly limits, why did you go over them?
The negotiations were supposed to be last week, but the Salarians stalled it, probably deliberately. If I don't get the stimulant, I'll be a wreck. My assistant will take over, and that would be a disaster.
What's wrong with him?
Is your assistant incompetent, or just inexperienced?
Worse. He's an alien sympathizer. My assistant wants to bend over backwards for the Citadel races. He wants to show them we're reasonable. No race will respect us until we show them who's in charge. That's what it took with the Turians. Forget my assistant.
Okay, I really don't know enough about the situation to judge.
Why is this deal so important?
The Salarians want to set up long-term trade agreements. There are billions of credits at stake. If I don't get the drug, my assistant will take over and mess up the whole deal. It would be a disaster.
Have a little faith.
You should put some trust in your assistant. Didn't you train him?
My assistant wants to bend over backwards for the Citadel races. He wants to show them we're race will respect us until we show them who's in charge. That's what it took with the Turians. Forget my assistant.
You're an addict.
Keeler, you've got a problem. You need to get treatment.
It might look that way from the outside, but this is just a one-time slip-up. All the top negotiators are on stimulants close to the legal limit. It's the way the game is played.
If that were the case, wouldn't they all be a bunch of gibbering drug-addicted maniacs by now? Don't be an idiot.
Will overdosing on stimulants and getting arrested help humanity, Keeler?
Maybe you're right. I've been trying to keep humanity strong, and maybe I've pushed myself too hard. I'll tell you what, this will be the last time I use the stimulant. After this deal is finished, I'll get treatment.
No, you'll go now.
You won't be doing humanity any favors if you overdose during negotiations. Get help now.
You don't understand! Humanity needs me, and I need that stimulant. Without it, I don't know anymore. I get so tired when I run out of the stimulant. I just need one more boost.
Listen to yourself.
That sounds like an addict talking, Keeler. What does it take to convince you?
You're right. I'll go tell my assistant. I shouldn't be working like this. I'll get help. Just sorry it came to this.
Shepard is like a more badass version of Captain Planet. Don't do drugs, or I'll bitch slap you into oblivion. Yeah. Well, that's that then.
Huh.
So let's talk to, Anderson. Anderson, my man. How you doing? Okay, let's save here. So we have completed. Yep. Alright. We've literally completed, I think, every side mission in the entire game. Only the final main quest.
I'm glad you came, Shepard. I heard what happened.
Now I know how you felt.
They pulled me off the mission. Just like when they forced you to give up the Normandy.
I know, I'm sorry. I wanted to warn you, but there was no way to get a message to you before you docked. I know you're pissed off right now, but you can't give up. They all think this is over, but we both know it's not. You have to go to Ilos. You have to stop Saren from using the conduit.
How?
There's only one ship that can get me into the Terminus systems undetected, and she's grounded.
Citadel controls locked out all the Normandy's systems, but if we override the ambassador's orders, we can get them to bring the Normandy back online. You can be in the Terminus systems before anyone even knows you're gone.
What happens to you?
If we steal the Normandy, you're the one left holding the bag.
And if Saren finds the conduit, life as we know it is over. The Reapers will destroy us. Humans, Asari, everybody. You're the only one who can stop him, Shepard. So I'll do whatever it takes to get you on the Normandy and off this station.
What about my crew?
Stealing the Normandy is mutiny. What if the crew won't help me?
The Normandy's your ship now, Commander. Her crew will follow you to the ends of the galaxy. We both know that.
Yeah, I mean, who's gonna stop me? Presley? yeah, that's... That'd be really funny, actually. Thank you.
I won't forget this, Captain. I promise.
I can unlock the Normandy from one of the consoles in the Citadel Control Center. You'll have a few minutes before anyone realizes what happened.
That's a restricted area patrolled by armed guards. How are you going to get in?
Leave that to me. Just make sure you're in the Normandy when the systems come back online.
Are there any other options?
There's got to be a better way.
Ambassador Udina issued the lockdown order. If I can hack into the computer in his office, maybe I can override it.
He won't just stand by while you use his computer.
Hopefully he won't be there. If he is, I'll just have to think of something.
The ambassador won't forgive this, Captain. He'll be charged with treason, a capital offense.
We don't have a lot of options. I break into the ambassador's computer, or I take my chances with the patrols in Citadel Control.
Go with the office. It leads to one of the best scenes in the entire game.
You'll have a better chance if you go after the ambassador's computer.
I was hoping you'd say that. The ambassador has made this personal. You ready to get the hell off this station, Commander?
I'm ready.
Let's do it.
I'll take care of the lockdown. You get down to the Normandy and tell Joker to stand by.
All right.
Terra Firma Party candidate Charles Saraceno confirms that the first human Spectre endorsed his candidacy.
All right. Interesting. Kind of a weird name. Saraceno. I don't know what country that name comes from. You must be really sick of me doing that by now. Alright, only one elevator to go. Only one last elevator. Let's do this. Let's do this a proper send-off.
Miners in the Skillian Verge are planning to resume operations on an asteroid rich in Element Zero. Raids by a criminal warlord had recently disrupted mining operations in the area. The warlord was subsequently killed, however, and infighting among his lieutenants has made future raids unlikely.
I have no idea who did it. Come on. Come on, no music. You're making me sad. Garrus, what are you doing? Look at him. that's funny. Get me out of here. Run.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in...
Here we go.
Anderson? What are you doing here? I didn't send...
Awesome.
Get us out of here, Joker. Now!
Like that little smirk on Joker's face for some reason. Not bad. That was pretty easy. Wonder how my crew is taking this.
Can't believe we stole the Normandy. I know we'll all be court-martialed if this doesn't work out, but part of me loves this.
Huh.
Can't believe we stole the Normandy. I know we'll all be court-martialed if this doesn't work out, but part of me loves this.
Who wouldn't? I'm a danger junkie.
Aw, damn it, no sign of pursuit? I was hoping the Council would send some ships after us. I was looking forward to putting the Normandy through her paces. Figured I'd get to see what this ship can really do.
Mission's not over yet.
Saren's still out there. Maybe we'll get a chance to play hide-and-seek with Sovereign.
You know, it doesn't seem like much fun when you say it, Commander. So you need something?
Tell me about your disease again, Joker. Okay, no. That's awful. That was a terrible joke. Goodbye.
I have to go.
All right, see you.
I'm a very inspiring Commander. Awkward.
Stealing an Alliance ship? Risky stuff. But I'm right behind you, Shepard. It's the least I can do.
Thanks.
Everyone else thinks I'm crazy.
Sometimes crazy is the best way to go. I just hope they don't catch us before we get our hands on Saren.
Trust me.
They won't.
With you, anything's possible.
Goodbye, Rex.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Does Garrus have anything to say?
I can't believe we stole the Normandy. I mean, I'm not surprised after everything you've told me, but still.
Scared?
You sound worried, Garrus.
No, not really. If you're wrong, we'll pay for it. But if you're right and we did nothing, I think we'd regret it a whole lot more. I just hope we can catch Saren before they realize we're missing.
Relax. We'll kick his ass.
We'll catch him. Just be ready when we do.
Yes, Commander.
Yep.
Commander, I wanted to thank you.
What for,
Garrus?
Come on.
This way, we'll know he'll never hurt anyone again. Don't worry, Commander. I will.
Alright, just want to make sure you had nothing new to say. Tele.
We're fugitives on the run. Very exciting, Shepard. I wonder what the Council would do to us if we got caught.
Wouldn't your dad help us?
Your father probably had some political pull, right? He wouldn't let them throw his little girl in jail.
You don't know my father. Stealing ships is a capital offense among my people. He'd probably want to execute us himself.
Nice guy. Don't worry about that.
We've got bigger problems than your father. Like Saren and the Reapers.
Good point. Was there something else you wanted to talk about?
Goodbye.
I should go.
See you later.
Yep.
Heard we're headed into the Terminus Systems, Commander. Don't worry, sir. The Normandy's a hell of a ship. She'll get us through this.
Mm-hmm. All right. We've got a real shot at this. Let's not waste it. Talk to Caden one last time, see if he has anything new. Have they do that silly animation every time we talk to him?
Anything you need, Commander? We're all in for the duration.
We'll talk
about that. Yeah. Alright. What about Chakwas?
It's strange. Being a fugitive from the Alliance. This crew has sacrificed everything for you, Shepard. Don't let us down.
I won't. Got it all under control.
This will all be over soon, Shepard. One way or another. This will all be over soon, Shepard. One way or another.
Well, that sounded ominous, Liara. This will all be over soon, Shepard. One way or another. Yeah, that's very inspiring. I feel so inspired now, guys. Alright. Let's get this party started. The party that will end all of their parties in the entire universe. Alright, let's go. Assume we can't go back to the Citadel, right? Right, obvious. What would happen if we went back to Virmire? Hmm. was just curious. Alright. Pangaea Expanse. Huh, cool place. Refuge. Interesting. Star system. Let's start the time warp again. Even though it's not a time warp, I don't know why I keep saying that. Zafe. Ajetotan. Whatever the hell that is. And finally, Ilos. Whoa, cool picture. In the golden age of the Protheans, Ilos was a verdant world, dotted with the spires and arches of magnificent cities. Even casual observation shows this is no longer the case. Ilos has been devastated by means unknown, its entire surface changed to the color of rust. The atmosphere shows heightened levels of oxygen. Wildfires, presumably ignited by lightning strikes, can be seen burning on the dark side. This indicates that most, if not all, respirating animal life forms have died off. Surface gravity is a comfortable 1.17 standard Gs. Alright. Let's do this. Whoa. That's cool. We already go through the mass relay. Those are Geth ships. This will be difficult.
Commander? We've got company.
Have their sensors picked us up yet?
Well, stealth systems are engaged. Unless we get close enough for a visual, they won't have any idea we're here.
Picking up some strange readings from the planet's surface.
Take us down, Joker. Lock in on the coordinates.
Negative on that, Commander. The nearest landing zone's 2 clicks away.
We'll never make it in time on foot. Get us something closer.
There is nowhere closer. I've looked.
Drop us in the Mako.
You need at least 100 meters of open terrain to pull off a drop like that. The most I can find near Saren is 20.
20 meters? We'll never get in close enough for a drop.
We have to try.
Find another landing zone.
There is no other landing zone!
The descent angle's too steep.
It's our only option.
It's not an option, it's a suicide run. We don't...
I can do it.
Joker?
I can do it.
Gear up and head down to the Mako. Joker, drop us right on top of that bastard.
All right. Let's do this. Tally and Garrus, two are with me. Go Team Dextro. For those of you who get that joke, good work.
You two, keep moving inside.
Here's Shepard, bitch. I wanted to run him over with a Mako.
We have to get inside this bunker before Saren finds the conduit. There's no way we're getting past that door with brute force.
Saren found a way to open it. There must be some kind of security override somewhere in this complex.
We'll have to find some way to get it up and running again.
Whoa. Take those guys out. Right. Yeah, that's not gonna work, is it? All right. Whoa. The hell are these things? That's creepy. Death trooper up ahead. Went over to behind this block here.
Whoa.
Okay. Got this thing. That's. Whoa, that's an armature. Shit. Not good, not good. Should take out that shock trooper. Let's throw. These guys do shoot about here. Left. Whoa, shit. That's not good. That's not good. Use lift, since lift does affect armatures. Hope it does. Use sabotage. Warp. Possible. Fire. Wait until it fires its gun. I'll hide behind here to bury her up just to be safe. Come on. Whoa. It's close. Another armature up ahead. These guys are sending in the heavy guns. Crap. That was a mistake. Come on, come on. It's freaky. Alright, reduce all this domino gel. Hello. Keep walking by. Not very talkative, are they? Before we go that way, let's go around this area, I guess. There's another enemy over there, but can't get to it yet. Look at this place. It is crazy. Most badass level in the entire game, without a doubt. Okay, open up this thing. Crap. This is the ultimate hacking. Yes, I did it. The Shepard is the winner. Hey, can't open that thing. Already explored over here, didn't we? Just making sure. Didn't miss anything. There's no hidden areas around here, that just leads to the door that we need to find a way to open, apparently. This place is creepy. Let's go down here. Oh shit. We're getting jammed here. Crap. Careful. Barrier up just to be safe. Whoa. Shit. Could snipe me easily from here. I gotta be careful. Killed it. Kill this thing.
All targets down.
Got one right here. We got that one. Okay. How many of these things are there? Whoa, something over there. Right. Whoa, still one more. I think just one more. All over now. That is creepy. Come on, die, die. What is that? What the hell? I really don't like this. Finish him off the throw. Yep. These statues are everywhere. No idea what the hell they are. Nothing good, I can imagine. Alright, let's move on. Would it be creepy if these statues like came to life and attacked us? That would be awesome. Like they're like some ancient Prothean defense system. I don't know. It could work. That would be creepy. What's interesting is they kind of look like husks. A little. Only with tentacles, like Cthulhu or something. Alright. Armor temperature control. What does that do? Okay, got some XP, but I don't know what it does. Yeah, it's something to do with those armatures back there. I got this gun assault drone. Easy breezy. Whoa. Shit. Come on. They took him out. So freaky, but so awesome too. Ancient ruins of long, long ago. All that is left of those who came before. Nothing here. All right. Come full circle because this, yep. Very interesting. So the only way to go would be this way, I guess. Remind me just going through the through your ancient halls of ages past. Just don't mind me. Those bees. What would Tally and Garrus have to say about all this?
My people once tried to find this world. We'd hoped we could settle here. But we didn't know it would feel so unwelcome. We shouldn't be here. Not us. Not the Geth. Not Saren.
There is something very wrong with this place.
My people once tried to find this world. We'd hoped we could settle here, but we didn't know it would feel so unwelcome.
There are secrets here that were meant to be forgotten. This place feels wrong to me, and not just because of the Geth. There are secrets here that were meant to be forgotten.
Well, those creepy statues certainly don't help. Alright. I think I'm going to end the episode here because I'm running out of time here, unfortunately. But I think I'll start the next episode as soon as I possibly can, so that's good to know. So, yeah. I'm going to end it right here. So, thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this episode, I definitely did, and if you really enjoyed my episode, please consider subscribing to my channel so that you'll be notified of when I release future content, and please leave a like or dislike, let me know what you think, and a comment is always welcome. Thank you, and goodbye.